Hey everybody, what is going on today? Welcome to the channel. Today we're going to be doing a video showing you guys exactly the best position you can possibly have your ball player be when doing the XP glitch in MLB The Show 21, all right? So you guys do me a favor, as always, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, man, subscribe. We're on the road to 3,000 subs, man. You guys are awesome. I really appreciate it. All the support's been amazing. It's free. Just hit that sub button for me. I appreciate it, you guys. Plus, you know, when we start doing giveaways down the road here in a little bit, you know, being a sub is going to help you get a chance to win. So here we go, man. We're going to get right into it. I've already gotten the inning boss, as you guys can see here. I posted that video late last night. So we went ahead and got through all of that. But here we go. We're going to go back in here into Road to the Show mode. I'm going to show you guys the best overall position that you can possibly be and the reasons why. For those specific positions, okay? When you go in here into your loadout and your My Ball Player and you pull up your loadout screen right here, you're gonna have all of these archetypes to complete. And a lot of these archetypes are gonna have different types of missions for you to get completed, all right? So they're gonna have different moments and different missions along the way as you guys go throughout this whole thing. And they're not gonna be the same for each one. This one in particular happens to be plate appearances, hits, assists and putouts. Now, plate appearances and hits, obviously you can do that with any one of them. I've made those videos showing you guys exactly how to do the XP glitch. So we're not going to go over all of that and exactly how to walk through that in this video. But you guys can check that link right there and it'll tell you. But the putouts and assists can be a difficult one to get, all right? Now, one of the other ones that's difficult to get is stolen bases. Stolen bases, unfortunately, it's not one doing the simulation glitch that you're going to be able to get. You're just going to have to simulate and get those other things to add up and instead of the stolen bases. If you want stolen bases, you're going to have to do it yourself. You will get them every once in a while, but it's once every blue moon. It's very rare. So the assist and putouts, though, you would think there's two positions that you would possibly think assist and putouts would be more likely to get at: first base and catcher. Now, catcher, the only issue with catcher is sometimes when you go into Road to the Show and you make your position as a catcher for your starter, a lot of times, you know, because it makes you start as a starting pitcher as well and do the two-way player thing at first, it seems to not play you in as many games. You ride the bench or you're a designated hitter a lot until you get to the major league level, and then they make you a catcher. Now, you would get putouts as a catcher by every strikeout that your pitcher throws, and with these glitches, your strikeouts are throwing a lot or your pitchers are throwing a lot of strikeouts. So, you know, that would be a great one to get. Assist. An assist happens when you field the ball and you throw the ball to a base and get an out. That person would get the put out. The person that made the throw would get the assist. Now, assists, you'll still be able to get at first base. Catcher, you'd be more likely to get on drop third strikes, possibly. But like I said, catcher doesn't really work as well. The one that'll move these the fastest is going to be first base. It's going to be first base in all of the archetypes. I recommend going ahead and making a Road to the Show player for first base every time if you're going to do these glitches. It doesn't matter what your archetype is. If your archetype says left field, like this one right here, I've been working on right here, and it shows the Crime Dog. The Crime Dog is a third base primary. You can barely see it right there. It's the first position just beside the webcam right there. Sorry about that. But yeah, man, it's so third base, but I've been playing him at first base. The missions are still tracking. There's no issue with that whatsoever. You guys can see that the missions are tracking. I've been doing it here. We're almost actually completely finished with this one. So, but first base is the best one because of those certain types of things that you're going to get. You know, in Tool Shed here, when we look at Tool Shed, some of the missions are going to be, these are just going to be plate appearances, hits. Now, this is one with stolen bases. This isn't that bad. Excuse me, because the stolen bases are a minor part of this. Some of your speedy programs are going to have more stolen bases and be more stolen base centric. Some of them are going to be all fielding based, and that's where first base is really going to come into play for you with those putouts. Every ball that's hit into the infield then is a putout at first base. You know, if you're playing shortstop or second or third base, you've got to have the ball hit to you or somebody making a throw and you covering that base. And you're much less likely to get as many per game. So at first base, that's where you're going to get the most ones. So if you guys have any questions about this, make sure to ask me. Let's check a couple of others of these real quick, though. Let's look at the Hawk. The Hawk one showed, what were the missions on this one? This was assist and putouts as well. So I haven't done a lot of the speedy ones yet. I'm kind of saving them for the end. And the reason is because of that Some of those missions are a little bit longer. This is hits, assists, putouts, and extra base hits. These are the ones that you you kind of want to look for, and first base is going to really help and benefit you out. To get you that XP as quick as possible. That's all we want to do, man. We want to get through that XP program as fast as we can, right? So I hope this video helps you guys out. Get grinded on that third inning program. You should be able to finish it really quick. And I should be able to get all the way done with it hopefully today. That's what I'm hoping. So, but y'all do me a favor, as always, man. Make sure to smash that like button. Subscribe to the channel. Subscribe. I can't thank you guys enough. It's been an amazing year, and we're going strong, man. So let's keep it up. But we'll catch you guys on the next one. Thanks. Peace.